noon during a precision daylight bombing raid on the submarine base and shipping facilities at Wegesak and Wilhelmshaven. The anti-aircraft defenses were unusually strong as the bombers started their runs over the target. The accuracy of our bombardment in the face of this concentration of flak brought a special letter of commendation from Prime Minister Churchill himself. Fires set by previous flights. Enemy pursuit ships. Our gunners drive them off. A Heinkel goes down. Bombs away. Enemy pursuit resumes its attack. Again, accurate gunnery beats them off. Homeward bound. Vapor trails streaming behind them. Trails of glory. For the first time, you'll be permitted to sit in on the interrogation of the crew of one of the bombers that made the raid. Their story will be more than the routine details of the action. It'll tell the whole saga of young America meeting the greatest crisis in our history.
Everybody here, Clark, McIntyre, Ward, Barnes, Baldrige. Were you on the radio, Baldrige?
Yes, sir.
Howard, Haviland, right waist, Haney, left waist, Reinhardt, Ball, Clayton, Tail.
Clayton?
Yes, right.
All right. How many enemy aircraft did you see today, about?
Oh, God, me.
Huh? 40.
40? 40? Yeah. What were they?
50.
What kind?
109.
Everything is
Pop
fine.
Popo
190.
Any ME-110s?
Yeah.
How did they attack today?
Oh, low attack.
Low?
A lot of them seem to be coming from the side. Level attacks from about 11 o'clock, 9 o'clock.
Any head-on attack?
I didn't see any. Only one. Reinhardt got that one from under from head-on.
Look, did you fellas notice their color and markings?
They're sort of mottled. Dull
wow.
Color.
Uh-huh. Did we use any defensive action?
Yeah, we...
That is other than gunfire.
The wing squadron converged on each other and diverged back and forth through that pursuit.
Any fighter support?
No,
none
at all.
How was the flak?
No.
Flak to the back of the target.
Heavy? Well, when did you first encounter flak, and where?
We first encountered flak, right by the target, wasn't it? Yes, on the run-in to the target, we encountered flak right about here.
Yeah. How was it? Accurate?
No, it was spotty and to our right. It wasn't very accurate.
Well, what color was it?
Black.
Black?
I don't think it was black
as
it was that sinking
was
there,
though.
Well,
it
wasn't
thick
there, that's right.
Tail gunner?
Yes, sir.
Did you see any flak today?
Why? You know what's the flak and what's the airplane? Boy, that group behind us really caught
hell. Was there any flak over the Wegesak?
Yeah,
heavy
flak.
Heavy
flak.
Accurate?
Accurate. Right on our left.
Was it black?
Yes, it was.
Sort of a dull.
Oh.
Wasn't it bright black? Couldn't see the flame out.
Bright black. Say, did you see any enemy signals, smoke screens, gummies?
Smoke screen at Wilhelmshaven.
Wilhelmshaven?
Right.
See any airdrome?
There's one airdrome just flew up.
Yes, that airdrome out of that island.
Which island?
Heligoland.
Heligoland.
It's underneath here.
There
it is, right up here.
That's
it.
Any convoys?
Yes, we saw one friendly convoy.
Where?
It was north of Cromer. Nine ships. We saw another tail gunner reported four ships and a
reported to five. It's just off of Milan.
Milan? Amalan.
Amalan.
Right.
Okay. Down off to the left here.
Now, there weren't any crew suggestions and comments.
I thought the formation was good. Good defensively. But it was living.
Yeah.
Everybody gave everybody else good supporting fire.
Armor plate?
Yeah,
doing it good?
I'm glad there's armor plate under me.
Why?
A piece of flak came right up under my seat.
Under your seat?
Right.
Smoked up the cockpit and the whole area.
You have any combat?
Boys.
Yes, we had about four attacks.
And, where was your first attack?
First attack was off of Smyrderny. I was about... about 1,500.
How high were you then?
We were 25,000 feet then.
Uh-huh. Where was it?
Were you on your way home?
No, we were on our way in. We were just off Nordirna, up here.
Yes.
And Ball Turret could tell you better about it.
Ball Turret?
Yes.
Where are you?
Sergeant Ryan.
Well, he just came in under our nose about 1 o'clock and scope out folding in to him. And I started firing and went on 200 and knocked him down.
We knocked him down. Anybody confirm that?
Yes.
Tail gunner?
Yes.
What happened to him, tail gunner?
He came on under smoking. And I fired a few rounds at him, but just let him know.
He went on under and made a bank to the right, took him right down into the water.
Into the water?
Okay.
Lots of circuit destroyed. Any other attacks?
I had one.
You had one?
Yes, that was on the way out.
On the way home? About what time, Navigator?
That was at 1605.
All right, what kind was it?
109.
Hemi 109. What happened to him?
Well, he just came in about 3 o'clock.
Huh? Can't hear you.
He came in about 3 o'clock and let him get in about 800 yards for up and firing.
And what gun were you operating?
Waist gun.
Which one?
The right.
Right waist gun. How many bursts did you let him have?
Oh, about five.
Five. What happened to him?
Well, he just went spinning down. Went into a full spin, didn't he? He turned off and went under the tail.
Anybody confirm that?
Tail gunner could see that very plainly.
You again, Clayton? What'd you see?
Well, I'm getting tired of going along for joy to be an observer.
Well, what did you see?
I wasn't fired at him. I think he must have hit the pilot. He seemed to stop, and he just started to slow the flat roll right on down.
On down where?
In the water.
You saw him crash into the sea, too? Anything else? Any other encounters?
No.
You got anything to say?
Not much.
Not much.
I'm too tired.
Too tired. You're dirty, too. You need a bath.
That's right.
The Army Air Forces, like any other big-time team, counts on every player to handle his assignment perfectly. If one player fails, the game can be lost. No one member is more or less important, just as no Air Force's plane is more or less important than any other. While the fighters run interference and the bombers smash over for the touchdowns, the transport is the workhorse of the team. Here in New Guinea, taking off from the world's only downhill runway, they show the power and strength of their construction. Lifting terrific loads of vital freight over vast stretches of ocean. They keep the American outposts closest to the enemy, supplied with crucial equipment and key personnel. Transports have made possible one of the war's greatest innovations, evacuation of the wounded by air. A high recovery rate among casualties is imperative in modern warfare. Swift treatment of the wounded is the only way to keep casualties down. In some areas, however, there are no base hospitals. But the big C-47s and C-53s take care of that. They sometimes carry their human cargo thousands of miles to adequate hospital facilities. These American boys will live to fight again. Because back home in the States, men and women are building these magnificent transports, building them bigger and better all the time. On time.